Thank you guys for coming. It really, I've said it before, but it's the best part of my week, working out with you guys. I do not work, I don't know. These live workouts just make me work out like 1,000 times harder, so. Okay, we're gonna start. Today we're gonna be doing upper body. And all you'll need, I said on stories like 10 minutes ago, two weights, a stack of books, which I need to get. And then a chair. So you will need like something, like a couch or a coffee table, something. We're gonna be doing just tricep dips on the chair. So, are we ready to start? So this week is just gonna be the Equal Justice Initiative. Maybe next week we'll do a different one, but I wanted to spend a lot of time on that one. I'm also donating all my ebook sales this week to that organization as well. The weights. So I have two different sets of weights. I have 8s and 10s, but you guys, again, you can find whatever you have around the house. Jars of anything, you can fill them with water to make them heavier. Laundry detergent, whatever you can find. So let me get started and explain the first circuit, and then we're gonna do a quick warm up, and then we're gonna get right into it. So the first circuit is gonna be 40 seconds on, 20 seconds rest. You guys know this format if you've done my workouts. So first we're just gonna be doing walkouts. This is just gonna wake everything up. You don't have to go all the way back to standing, but you do want to come all the way into a high plank where your hips are in line with your shoulders and your heels. Thank you. And then come back up. And you can even bend your legs if you want. But the idea is you want to speed it up. Work the upper body. The next exercise, you have weighted squat to press. So you can grab your weights, whatever you have. We're going to be doing feet are hip width apart. You're going to squat down. Your knees are not going inward. You want them straight over your toes or even just a little bit outwards. Bring it up to a curl and then a press. Back down that curl. All right. That's number two. And then number three, we're going to bring it down into a plank. We have plank step outs to shoulder reach. So we've done this one, I think I just did this on a swipe up. I don't know if I've done this on a live before. You're gonna get down into a forearm plank. You're gonna alternate between each lateral toe tap and then a shoulder raise. So keep in mind you wanna keep a wide base on your feet or else when you do the shoulder reach, you're gonna lean and your hips are gonna rotate, which you do not want to happen. You want your hips to be stable, parallel to the ground the whole workout. So lateral toe tap, shoulder reach, shoulder reach. Right? Shoulders will burn after that. So that's all in circuit one. And then I'll explain circuit two once we get into it. But let's get a little warm up going. Today. Speed it up. High knees. Jump step.
Thank you.
press. So on the curl, you want your elbows in to your sides. Press up, 3, 2, 1. Squat down, curl, press up overhead. And on the way down, you're doing that reverse equine curl.
Alright, get some water. Catch your breath. I'm already sweating.
be going four rounds through. Bridger hates when I do this. He hates when I put like a timed exercise in a circuit that's not timed, but he's not here, right? So we're gonna be doing weighted high knees for 30 seconds to start out this round. So you're gonna hold that weight, whatever you can find. Seriously, this is just a 10-pound medicine ball. Bring those knees up. You're not leaning back. You wanna keep your form straight. Chest is a little bit up, shoulders are back. And you're gonna feel it in those biceps. Alright, 30 seconds for that. Then we have, we're gonna use our stack of books. If you guys don't have one, you can run and get one real quick. Or something that's elevated. We're gonna be doing uneven push-ups. We haven't done this for a while. I remember last time we did this, I was so sore the next day. So you can keep the stack of books in the center of your mat. We're gonna bring it up to a standard push-up because so many of you guys are saying that you can do full push-ups now. Literally makes my day. Standard push-up. Your weight is gonna be. The weight is gonna be in the center between your left palm and the book stack. So you're not farther on one arm than the other, you're in the middle. You're gonna bring it down. Keep that form. And then you can always drop to your knees if you need to towards the end. All right? Chest stays lifted. We're gonna be doing six on each side. So we're gonna rotate to this side. So that's one round, we have four. Next one, we have bicep curl to wide press. I've done this in my swipe through videos before. I recommend a lower weight if you have an option. You want to keep your elbows close to your body here. Your palms are going to face out. So you're going to curl out instead of the standard curling palms up to the sky. Curl out. Once you're here, you have a wide press out. Bring it back down, elbows to your side. Okay? We got 10 of those. Next one. We have a bent over row to a high pull. You can grab your weights again. We have a bent over. So remember, you're hinging at your hips. Hinge at your hips. Hinge at your hips. Slight bend in your knees. Your shoulders are back. Your chest is slightly lifted. There's no arch. There's no major arch in your back right here. And you're not rounding your back here. Form is straight. Go all the way down. Your feet can be a little bit closer than hip width apart. Row. Stand up, high, pull. Row. You want to keep the weights close to your body here. And then you're going to lower them back down, stand up to a high pull. So combine those together. One fluid motion. Okay? So one of each exercise counts as one rep here. And we have 10. So that's it. Four exercises in that circuit. We have four rounds through. We ready? Okay. Starting with your weighted high knees. 3, 2, 1. I want you guys to push it for 30 seconds. Hold that weight here. If you want to get real advanced, you can hold it above your head, but drive those knees up. Keep breathing. I'll turn the music up after this one. 10 more seconds. Breathe. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Whew. Drop that weight. How do you feel? Do you hate that one? Okay, making sure it's not cutting out. Next up, we have uneven push-ups, so grab your stack of books. Center of your mat. Let's start on your left side, so your left palm is on the side of the books. Bring it up, we got 6 each. Let's go, you guys. Check your form. 2. 4, 5, 6, it's about to get real hard, round 4. Cool. Get water if you need. Grab those weights, we have bicep curl, 2 quad raises. We got 10 reps. Ready? Palms are out. Elbows in. Let's go. and done. Take an extra second to really focus on the muscles you're using. Does this guy need to leave? Hiding from Chase. Working so hard on the other side. All right, guys. We can do it. Grab that weight. We have 5 seconds. We're in high knees. Last 30 seconds. Go. Bring them up. Breathe through it. Keep your forearm, your back is straight. Shoulders are back. And your chest is lifted. Grab them up. Do not quit on us. We're in it together. 8 seconds. Do not stop. Don't quit. 3, 2, 1. High five me. You guys are crushing it. Woo! My baby hairs are coming out to play. It means it's a good workout. All right, grab those books. Last set of uneven push-ups. Push yourself. Picture me in your head while you guys are doing this on your own. Push yourself. You can do a full stand push-up. 6. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Last round. 5, 6. Switch sides. Don't think about it. Just do it. Go. 1, 2. Take a breath between each. 3, 4. Two more. 5, last one. 6. Oh, I'll let everyone finish. I'm so proud of you guys. Those are not easy. Especially because we're doing 4 rounds of them. Oh. Catch your breath. Grab those weights for the last dumbbell portion. Ready? Let's go. Elbows are near your body. Wait, what am I doing? You guys, hold me in check. Okay. Curl out to wide press. 1, 2, breathe. Slide bend in your knees. 3, your back is straight. Your shoulders are out and back. 4. 5. More than halfway. 7. Don't stop breathing. 8. Elbows in. 9. Last one. 10. Good job. All right. Keep your weights. Last round of bent over rows to high pull. We can do it. Let's go. Stand up to high pull. That's 1. This is not for speed. This is for form. 3. 1 fluid motion. 4. We got it. 5. Not feeling this, hold it for another 1 to 2 seconds at the top. 7. 8. 9. Last one, you guys. Weights in your heels. 10. Boom. Done with circuit 2. We got 2 more quick ones. 2 more quick circuits. Okay. Circuit 3 is gonna be 30 seconds on, 15 second rest for 3 rounds through. This is where you're gonna need your chair, your bench, whatever you wanna use to do a tricep dip on. No more weights or books this entire workout. All want. Come back up to the top where your chest is lifted. Or you can start with your knees bent. Either way, we're here for 30 seconds. Next one, we have mountain climbers for 30 seconds. So, your hips are in line. Standard mountain climbers. Three rounds. Ready, guys? Let's do it. In three, two, one. These are gonna be tough, but just breathe through it. You can alternate if you want between straight leg and bent knee. We got 10 seconds, you guys. Three, two, and one. Woo, shake it out. We got 15 seconds. Three, we're mountain climbers. Two, one. Engage that core. Make this a core exercise. Your shoulders are stacked over your wrists.
Your elbows and your wrists.
second. Are you guys' arms dead? Take a breather. I'm gonna explain the last circuit of this whole workout. All right? We are so close. All right. You guys, we only have 15 seconds with laydown push-ups. That's it. That's enough time for you to get as push yourself. I don't even know how many. Where your feet are concrete to the floor. They're not moving. Extend your palms out in front of you. Bring them back to your chest. You want to push up with both your hips and your chest at the same time. So not just your shoulders. You're not here. You want to extend up. Use that upper body strength and that core strength. Lower yourself back down. All right. Push yourself as hard as you can go for 15 seconds. That's it. Then we have side plank reach throughs. 15 seconds each side. Excuse me. So you can do a staggered stance at the bottom. See my feet. We're reaching through and bringing it back to the top. We have 15 seconds each side. When you guys alternate, just do a rolling plank, and then you're here for another 15 seconds. You want to reach through underneath between your elbow and your hips. Feeling your obliques, and then only bring your palm up towards parallel with your shoulder. You're not bringing it back. Bring it straight up, and then your gaze follows your palm the whole time. All right? We can do it. We're so close. Ready? 15 seconds each exercise. I know you guys can do it. Starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Lay down push up. This is a burnout. Push yourself here. 3, 2, 1. Okay, 15 second break. Enough time for you to get in a side plank. So you can do that reach through. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, reach through. Bring it back up, palm is parallel to your shoulder. Speed it up. 15 seconds each side. 3, 2, 1, switch. Remember, rolling plank, right to the other side. No break between. Feel those obliques. 3, 2, 1. Look good. You guys can stay here on the floor. Oh, we have 10 more seconds. Then we have the lay down push-ups again. 5, 4, 3. Please do it. If you need a modification, go. Go, go, go. You're on your knees. Okay? Try your arms to stay in the standing push-up. We only have 15 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Good job. Ooh. Easy, right? All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We have 15 seconds here. Reach through. Breathe. Bring that palm up straight overhead. 3, 2, 1, switch. Almost in our last. last one. In three, two, one. Reach through between that elbow and those hips. Can you feel it? We have five, four, three, two, switch. Last 15 of the whole workout. Don't stop. Squeeze that core. We got five, four, three, two, and one. Oh man. So proud of you guys. Get some water. Okay, now is the time. If you want to donate, please use the donation sticker. We're donating to the Equal Justice Initiative. Really, really, really good organization. I also just put up a resources guide on my blog. If you guys want to look into more ways to educate, learn, donate. And I would love if you guys want to comment on that blog post and let me know more resources so I can add it. But you guys crushed this upper body workout. Yeah, let's do some stretches. Times it. Yeah, we have a little bit. Crush some stretches. All right. Bring it down to the floor. How do we feel, by the way? Can everyone just send a flex for me and high five. Last circuit was hard. Last two circuits were hard. All right, so you're gonna be on your knees here. You're gonna bring your right arm through your left palm and your knee. And you're gonna basically rotate your whole torso. Your knees stay in place. You're gonna stretch that shoulder. Your traps. This is a very awkward pose right here. But you're basically reaching through, resting on that right shoulder. And you can even press your left hand into the mat to extend even further. This is one of my favorite back stretches, sorry. I always get knots in the same spot in my back, and this one always helps. Big deep breath. Good, switch sides. Oh, left hand goes through. Ooh, your knees are in place. Oh, you can push with that right palm. So you're leaning even more into that left shoulder. This is the most awkward angle. One more deep breath. Good. Tricep. We definitely worked our triceps today. Just reach back for your spine and then press with your opposite hand. $2,300, you guys. We passed our 5,000 mark this week. I appreciate you guys. Thanks for working out with me and all of us Saturday. I love our Good Sweat community. It's gonna be next week, we'll do 90s theme booty and core. You guys had a say in this today. And it's gonna be at 9 a.m. Pacific time, per usual. Thank you guys, love you so much. Have the best weekend, and we will talk soon. Goodbye, we ended with $3,353. Are we still getting some? Maybe I'll pick a new organization next week. Okay, I'm gonna go. Love you guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.